Gaussian elimination is the workhorse for solving large systems of linear equations. We learned about Gaussian elimination in my matrix algebra course, where we dealt with like 3x3 matrices, and we just went through the matrix using Gaussian elimination. Now, in a numerical methods course, we have to learn how to do Gaussian elimination on the computer, and we're typically dealing with hundreds or thousands of equations. Okay, what works when you deal with three equations may not work anymore when you deal with thousands of equations because of the problem of round-off error. So we've touched on round-off error in the beginning of this course, and here I'm going to show you how the basic Gaussian elimination procedure without pivoting. Pivoting means that you can swap rows in the matrix. So if you go through Gaussian elimination in a large matrix without swapping any rows, even when the pivot is not zero, you may end up with completely wrong results. In this video, I'll give you a somewhat contrived example to illustrate how you can get a wrong result. But because I'm only doing a 2x2 matrix, it may seem like a fake example. But in fact, it's valid because small round-off errors in very large matrices will accumulate with each Gaussian elimination procedure. So a thousand small errors can be equal to just one catastrophic error. So to understand the problem, let's go back to the beginning of the course and remember what machine epsilon is. Remember EPS, and here I'll just use the epsilon symbol, is 2 to the minus 52, which is about 2.2 times 10 to the minus 16. So it's a very small number, but it's the number that tells us the distance between 1 and the next largest number. It's actually the distance between any number between 1 and 2 and the next largest number, okay? Because that's the definition of machine epsilon, in the computer, if we try to compute 2 plus machine epsilon, computationally, because the distance between 2 and the next largest number is twice machine epsilon, 2 plus machine epsilon will just give us 2. Similarly, 4 minus machine epsilon will give us 4. Okay? That will be our fundamental round-off error in my example. And I'll show you how this round-off error will result in a completely wrong solution if you just apply Gaussian elimination like we did for small matrices in my matrix algebra course. So let's look at a system of equations to solve. So I'm going to solve the equation epsilon times x1 plus 2x2 equal to 4. And then x1 minus x2 is equal to 1. If we look at this system, we can kind of approximate the solution. Epsilon is a tiny number. Epsilon times x1 we can neglect. And then x2 is approximately 4 divided by 2. So x2 is approximately 2. And if x2 is approximately 2, then 3 minus 2 equals 1. So x1 is approximately 3. Okay? Our numerical algorithm for solving this system of equations should give us a solution x1 equals 3, x2 equals 2, or at least something very close to that, okay? Let's apply Gaussian elimination now and see what we get. So remember how to do Gaussian elimination. We set up the augmented matrix. So we have an epsilon and a 2, and then a right-hand side 4. And we have a 1 and a minus 1 and a right-hand side 1. Now we do Gaussian elimination. So the first row stays the same, epsilon 2, 4. Then we multiply by minus 1 over epsilon and add to eliminate this 1. So we have minus 2 over epsilon minus 1. And we have a minus 4 over epsilon plus 1. Okay? And that completes the Gaussian elimination for a 2 by 2 matrix. Okay, so this is two equations. So let me write the equations. So minus 2 over epsilon minus 1 times x2 is equal to minus 4 over epsilon plus 1. Okay, that's the right-hand side. So I'm writing the bottom equation first, and then I'll write the top equation. So the top equation is epsilon x1 plus 2x2 equals 4, okay? So I wrote it in that order because we're going to look at the first equation first. I want to simplify that equation. So I want to clear the denominator so I can multiply both sides of this equation by minus epsilon. So then we end up with 2 plus epsilon times x2 equals 4 minus epsilon. Okay? So because these equations are contrived, I've put myself exactly in the situation where 2 plus epsilon equals 2, right? So this one will then give us, using machine arithmetic, 2 plus epsilon equals 2. So this is 2 times x2. And 4 minus epsilon equals 4. So this is 4. So immediately we get x2 is equal to 2. So far we're not in trouble. X2 equals 2 is an excellent approximation to the exact solution. But now we get in trouble when we go to the second equation here. So this one, we're trying to solve for x1 and x2 equals 2. So if I substitute in x2 equals 2 and bring it to the right, we get epsilon x1 is equal to 4 minus 2x2, which is 4, exactly 4, because x2 is exactly 2, right? X2 is the integer 2. It's not approximately 2, it's exactly 2. So 4 minus 4 is exactly 0, which when we solve this for epsilon, a very small number times x1 gives us 0, means x1 equals 0, exactly 0. That's a problem because x1 is approximately 3, right? So this is completely wrong. This is not even close, completely wrong. Okay? Where was the problem? The problem is the round-off error, which I contrived this problem to have. 2 plus epsilon equals 2, 4 minus epsilon equals 4. So x2 is exactly 2. The next equation is supposed to be a very small number times x1 is equal to 4 minus 2x2. So 4 minus 2x2 cannot be exactly 0. It must be a very small number. So then we would have a very small number and a very small number, and then it's possible that x1 is equal to 3. But that doesn't happen because of round-off error. Let me summarize. In my matrix algebra course, I taught you how to do Gaussian elimination on small size matrices, 3 by 3, say. And we didn't worry about things like having to switch rows. We switched rows when the pivot was 0, but when the pivot was something other than 0, we didn't have to bother with switching rows. If you're doing a thousands of equations and unknowns, if you never switch rows, if the pivot is small, not exactly zero, but small, then you will accumulate a round-off error. So by a round-off error, I mean you start losing significant digits in your numbers. And as you keep going through the Gaussian elimination process, you can keep losing more and more significant digits until your number, your answer, becomes meaningless. This is an extreme case, but it happens almost all the time for random matrices with thousands of equations and unknowns. So we need to solve this problem. The solution to this problem is called partial pivoting, and I'll explain what that is in the next video. I'm Jeff Chasnoff. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.